noise to the rhythm. One, two, and three. So there's a whole bunch, that's fantastic. How many of you have been hypnotized before? So a few of you. And that's fun because we might get a few of you up here. The only thing I'll need besides your wonderful minds and bodies, and this is the most important thing here tonight, is your safety, because there's so many of you here and we need to make sure that you don't get hurt up on the stage. So before I call you up, let's get you to make sure that we have a clear path on either side. And on the count of three, any and all of you that want to come up, get your hands in the air. I'm going to start picking some of you. Again, if I don't get you, I haven't even started to count. On the count of three, get your hands up in the air, and I'm going to start to pick you. One, two. Was there somebody that was hypnotized last time? Was that you? No, the time before? No. You were? We might get somebody that's been hypnotized before, but we got to get a few of you. One, two, I'm going to start picking some of you. Keep it on, keep it on. You got two, you got two from the village, but we're getting you up, we're getting two of you. We're getting you up, we're getting you up. Watch, watch it, watch it, watch it, watch it. Keith, we're going to get a few up here. Yeah, fantastic. Hold it. You're going to have to hold my mic.
Hi, Sarah.
Okay. Is there any room in the back here? Okay, for all of you that are standing right now, if you can take a chair, great, but one of the chairs is really close to the edge, so just take a chair, take a chair, take a chair. Fantastic. All of you that are standing, don't worry, you're not gonna get kicked off. You're gonna just come right behind here and you're gonna stand behind these people. Yeah. First of all, because, again, of the space limitations, for this to work really quickly, who's been hypnotized before? If you have, just put up your hand. There's a few of you. Okay, what's your first name? Duncan? Do you remember when you got hypnotized? Was it with me? Okay, I need Duncan to switch with you. What's your name? Kamal? Okay, hold it. Your first name?
Luke.
Luke, we're getting to switch with Duncan right now. Come here. And then you get this kid over here. Okay. The reason why, Duncan, is that anybody who's been hypnotized before will be easy. I mean, easily hypnotized. You go into this very quickly. Push back a little bit, push back a little bit, push back, you need to pay attention. And for all of you that are standing, at no time that you fall, your legs are strong beneath you, will not fall. If you are pushed in with other people, it's probably best if you're standing. So what does that mean?
You get to stand behind there.
And I know my back's turned to you. So, for all of you, put your hands on your lap, feet flat on the floor, and now raise your right hand and wave at everybody in the audience.
Bye-bye.
Put your hands down. Now, some of you are going to get hypnotized very quickly. A couple things that I'm going to kind of go over is this. You're going to hear me at all times. That's what hypnosis is that you are aware, you just don't care. And if you're focused in on me right now, you're going to do great. But if you're distracted in many ways, you'll probably go out and watch the show. And any time if I ask you to watch the show, it just means you need more time to relax. Make sense? Good. Duncan, how long will it take you to get hypnotized?
I don't think too long.
What's that?
I hope not too long.
It worked for you last time?
Yeah.
What if I told you it was going to take you 1 second to get hypnotized?
No.
You don't believe it? Okay, in a moment, Duncan, I'm going to hypnotize you. In a moment, nothing else matters except you and I and me hypnotizing you. I'm looking at you and I'm giving you full attention. In a moment, I'm going to get you to close your eyes. And when I tap you on the forehead, is it Kamal? And say the word sleep, you're going to relax so deeply that you sleep upon Kamal. Do you think that will happen? You don't know, do you? But it takes 1 second. Deep breath in. In a moment, I'm going to hypnotize you. Let it out of the side. In a moment, it's going to take 1 second. Deep breath in. Duncan, look at me. Close your eyes. Sleep. Relaxing every muscle of your body. Now, Duncan has just displayed how easy it is to get into a state of relaxation. And in a few moments, he's going to be doing some really weird things. And watch how very relaxed he is up here. Yeah. On a count of three, Duncan, you'll be wide awake. And the challenge is that obviously not everybody's going to be able to see this. So you kind of got to position yourself where you can see best. On a count of three, Duncan, you'll be wide awake, fully aware. On three, you don't really believe you're hypnotized. However, anytime I shake your hand and say the word sleep, you're out like a light. One, two, three. Eyes open, Duncan. Duncan, couple questions. First of all, I said it would take a couple seconds or a second to get hypnotized. Does it feel like you got hypnotized today or?
No.
You didn't get hypnotized yet?
No.
No? Well, give me your hand. Sleep deep in a relaxation. Thanks for being a friend, Kamal. Now this is where it gets really, really, really cool and fascinating. He's going to accept the suggestion. He won't be able to get his hands apart. On a count of three, Duncan, you'll open your eyes. You'll interlock your hands together. You're going to lock tight. You're going to lock solid. And the moment I snap my fingers, you picture, imagine, and pretend you cannot get them apart. So much, in fact, you can't get them apart. You get really, really frustrated because you can't get your hands apart. And then when I point to Kamal, you think he crazy glued your hands together. At no time do you touch them or get physically violent. You just get angry with him. One, two, three. Eyes open, Duncan. Duncan, do this.
Interlock your hands together. Lock them tight.
Lock them solid and look at your hands as I want you now to picture, imagine, and pretend to become pretty glued. So crazy glued, the more you try to take your hands apart, the more they're locking tighter and tighter. Can you get them apart? No way?
No.
And I know who did that. Come on. You should see his face. You should see his face. You should see it. Are you mad? Shame on you, Kamal. Hey, you're not going to dance for us up here, are you?
No.
And just sleep deep in a relaxation. Let's give him a big round of applause. Now, here's the Here's the fact of the matter. He is going to dance for us. I'm going to give you guys just a perspective, a little bit of perspective. Okay, so here's how it works. No, you guys keep there. Stay there. So Duncan hears me at all times, and to prove this, on a count of three, Duncan, your hips start shaking in their seat. They'll go side to side, side to side, and you keep your eyes closed. You can't stop your hips. One, two, three, your hips start going side to side. It's the weirdest thing that happens here. And as they go side to side, on the count of three, your eyes will pop open, but you have no idea why your hips are moving. And you can't stop your hips. One, two, three, eyes open up. Duncan, okay. Can I ask you, what are you doing?
I don't know.
You're shaking your hips. Now try and stop your hips, you won't be able to. Isn't that weird?
A little bit.
Well, a lot weird, because on the count of three, you stand up and your hips shake even more. One, two, three. And do you know why you're doing it? Do you know why you're doing this?
No.
It's called warming up, because when you hear the next piece of music, you shake your hips as hard as you can and you dance to the music. Duncan, what are you doing?
I don't know.
We're trying to do a hypnosis show and you're just dancing all in the middle of the stage. You just sit down, okay? But before you sit down, I gotta tell you one thing. That's a sleep seat. When you sit down in that, you'll fall asleep and you'll just pass out upon, come on. You don't believe that. Sit down. Yeah. Give him a big round of applause. He's doing it. Sleeping deeper right there. Okay, now we're gonna get started. Front of you on stage. And you know what? We're gonna try the other mic just for a second because it keeps cutting out this one. I'm gonna just see if it's different at all. So for all of you, deep breath in. Let out the sigh. For any and all of you that are standing, check. For any and all of you that are standing, I want all of you to think of yourselves as a tree that does not fall. You're gonna stay standing. We're gonna just give you the other mic. Take a deep breath in. Sure. Okay, take a deep breath in. Let it out with the sigh. You're gonna hear some music, and this music needs to relax. At any time if I tap you in the forehead, it means to relax completely, like Duncan. You'll hear me at all times, trust me. If you don't hear me, you are asleep. And that's not sleep over here. Deep breath in. Now just close your eyes. As you keep your eyes closed, what I want you to do right now, come all, let's not look around. So I want you to keep your eyes closed, and so you can concentrate on one thing, roll your eyes to the back of your head as if you're looking at the ceiling. Now I want you to imagine that your eyes are completely crazy glued, tightly locked shut. Now, so crazy glued in fact, the more you try to open your eyes, the more they'll be locking tighter and tighter and tighter down. You know, if you really wanted to open up your eyes, you could, and yet that's not why you're here. You're here to relax and go deeper into relaxation. So just let go of your eyes, relax them, and I'm going to send the numbers from 3, 2, 1. On one, you get to relax, let your chin drop to your chest, relax upon the person next to you. If you're standing, stay in a solid position. For all of you sitting, I'm going to descend 3, 2, 1. At that moment, your chin may want to drop, your shoulders may want to slouch. And anytime if you push up against the person next to you, let yourself relax. And at all times, stay in your seat. 3, relaxing every muscle, nerve, and fiber of your body. 2, feeling better than brand new. On this next count, just let your mind relax, let your body loosen, and follow my suggestions, and it happens now. 1, sleep deeper. Stay in your seat, stay in your seat, stay in your seat. And as you go deeper into relaxation, the deeper you go, the better you feel. I'm going to descend the numbers again. 3, relaxing every muscle, nerve, and fiber of your body. 2, feeling better than you've ever felt. On this next count, let yourself relax. Stay standing if you're standing. And follow my suggestions. It happens now. 1, sleep deeper. As you go deeper into relaxation, the deeper you go, the better you feel. For each and all of you, you're feeling fantastic. You're relaxing every muscle and every fiber of your body. And I want you now just to imagine that your left arm and wrist has a helium balloon attached to the wrist. Helium balloon is so light it's going to pull your left arm higher and higher. As you picture and imagine that your arm rising and lifting and rising and lifting, your left arm starts to rise and lift and rise and lift. As you imagine this to be true, your left is starting to go higher and higher. Your left is starting to go higher and higher. Your right just stays there, but your left goes higher and higher. And as your left goes higher and higher, just continue the process of rising and lifting and lifting and rising and lifting and rising. As your hands start to lift and rise, that's just your left one. For anybody that I ask to leave at this point, just me needing more time to relax. Lifting and rising, rising and lifting. Your left goes higher. Left goes higher. At any point when I come around to you and tug your wrist, just let your body relax. And any time if I ask you to leave the stage, it just means you need more time to relax. Sleep. Sleep. When I tug your wrist, just let yourself melt and relax. Straight out in front of you. Lock them tight as if they're like a steel bar or one piece of wood carved out of one piece of wood. Look at your hands, look at your thumbs, and now lock them tighter. And now I want you to picture, imagine, and pretend they crazy glued. So crazy glued you can't get them apart no matter how hard you try. Give them an honest try, give them an honest try. The weird thing is that you can't get them apart no matter how hard you try. And then when I push your hands down, you just let yourself melt and relax, just sleep. And just sleep, nice and easy. Just sleep deeper, nice and easy, just sleep. Yes, perfect. And sleep right there. Sleep right there. Perfect. Sleep. 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 Sleeping over here. Yeah, we'll get you over here. Sleeping here. Sleep. Sleep. Good. Sleep. Sleep. And sleep. And yeah, we've got a few people I know in the crowd that can't get their hands apart. And it's a good thing that they're not too close to the stage. And I'm on the phone, yes. So for all of you in the stuck there, you gotta stay in your seat. Stay in your seat. And sleep. And Duncan, he won't be able to get his hands apart. So for the people in the audience, you can get your hands apart on the count of three. And you will also think, the moment that you get your hands apart, you will think that you're not hypnotized. However, anytime I say the word hypnosis, you think it's the funniest thing in the world, and you'll laugh hysterically. You get to move over one, you get to move over, you come over here. We're going to spread you out a little bit here. You get to move over one, you get to move over one, you get to move over one. Perfect. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Good, 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 good. Come on over. And you can sit right there. Good. You get to come here. You get to come here. We are actually going to put you back there and switch. And then you get to sit right over there. Great. Okay, we're going to find out who's here. And very loudly, just tell me your name.
Brett.
Are you having fun so far?
Sleep.
You can relaxation. And your name?
Stephanie.
Stephanie, you've been waiting to come up, huh? Did you get hypnotized?
No.
Sleep. Dean, stuck in your seats. Stuck in your seats. Hey, Dan, you're next. Tell you what, Dan, I'm going to give you the power to hypnotize people. Would you like that? All you have to do is do the hypnotic look. It's like this. Do that. Just like this. Give it a shot. That didn't look like the hypnotic look. I'll tell you what, you can do the hypnotic tap. All you have to do, and your first name is? Sarah. As you tap Sarah on the forehead, it should be out like a light. Just lightly though, okay? Sleep right over here, stuck there, sleep there, sleep there, stuck there. Okay, now watch how this works. Okay, sleep right over here. So, yeah, you can just stop right there. Now, no one goes out of their seats, no one goes back. But I want all of you in the back there, when I close my hand to a fist, to close your eyes and melt. You'll hear me in all time. Sit back in your seats, deep breath in. 3, 2, all of you, 1, sleep. Deep breath relaxation. Perfect. Dan, you're going to have some more fun, okay? You're going to hypnotize Duncan right away. Watch this. You're just learning here. And your name is?
Trina.
Trina, good man. Sleep. Right there, Trina. Stuck there in your seat, Trina, at all times. What are you laughing at?
Bradley.
And your name?
Chris.
Chris, what grade are you in? 12. So, what are you doing after high school? Do you have an idea? Do you go to the university? Or? Right, we're going to have some fun up here. That's what we're going to sleep. Deep into relaxation. Stuck there together. Oh, okay. Dan, did you do that? Sleep. Actually, when you wait, you get switch seats. Okay? Because Dan's going to hypnotize Duncan here right away. Actually, you two have hypnotic eyes. I'm not kidding. When you look at each other, you put each other to sleep. Don't look at each other yet. When you put each other to sleep, you do not fall out of your seat and stay in your seat. Look at each other now. See how powerful they are? Now, you got the power. Smile, man. There. It's like he's in hypnosis. And now, get your fingertip up. Tap Duncan in the forehead and get like a light like that. See, you did it. Say, yeah, I did it. Now do this. See what happens. Let's hear the stars. Now this is where it gets great, because we're going to take you on a journey through your imagination. For all of you on stage, it's like you're going to go through a world tour through your imagination. I'll be your guide tonight. And for all of you, you don't even have to leave your seats, you don't even have to leave your bikes, you don't even have to leave where you're standing, because you're going to come along with us. For all of you on stage, I want you to think of yourself as the world's greatest musician. What that means is that you're auditioning for a symphony orchestra, and you're going to play the instrument, and if we can have no one on stage, that would be great, because I just don't want anybody getting hurt up here. So for all of you, I want you to think of yourself as the greatest musician in the world. You're going to be wearing your best clothes, you're going to be keeping your eyes closed, and picking up the instrument. Maybe you've never even played it before, but you believe and you act as if you're the greatest musician in the world. So sit up now, keep your eyes closed. Pick up the instrument of your choosing now. Keep your eyes closed. And start to tune it up. Start to really tune it up. And as you start to tune it up, keeping your eyes closed. On a count of three, you play to your heart's content. The more noise you make, the more they get into it. 1, 2, and 3. Thank you. It's tough to actually pick one person out of here to bring on the journey. In fact, all of you did such a great job. You're all going to be part of the Symphony Orchestra. You're super excited, you're smiling, and you're all going to get $100,000. Oh, you are pumped. You're charged. And guess what? You don't even have to start working. You don't even have to start performing, because the first stop is the beach. Oh, and you love the beach. You love that beach, so you want to sit up and you want to start suntanning. Now, keeping your eyes closed. Just kick back, start the suntan. And as you start the suntan, you got a refreshment in your hand. Start to drink that refreshment. And you realize that you're out of the refreshment, so call over the cabana boy or cabana girl, they'll come over. They come over, they're hardly wearing anything, not right. They fill up your drink and you start drinking some more. You're getting your thirst quenched, but you realize that you're out of the drink. So you feel really hot, put your drink down, now you feel like you have to wave your hand in front of your face to cool yourself off. Start cooling yourself off. As you're waving with one hand, wave with two hands now. As you're waving with two hands, try to stop the waving because you can't, and it's really interesting because you're starting to morph into a beautiful little butterfly that loves to spread your arms as if they're wings now. Yes. Keep your wings to yourself, but show us that you're the prettiest butterfly in the world, Dan. Yeah. You love to smile, and you have a signature move. Show us your signature move now. Stay in your seat, though. Stay in your seat. Whew. Yeah, she's excited back there. And on the count of three, you're going to be in the North Pole. On three, you shake, shiver, and freeze. One, two, and three. Do not move your seat. Do not move your seat. Stay in your seat. Here comes a wisp of wind. It's cold. But there's one thing you can do, one thing. The person next to you, they have body heat. Cuddle with them now. Stop there. Okay, stay in your seat. Stay in your seat. And on the count of three, you all sleep together. And you stay in your seats, do not fall out, stay in your seats. One, two, and three. Sleep in your seats. Stuck there, stuck there. Let's hear it. Energy! This is crazy! This is so much energy tonight, it's hard to contain it. Look at that. Look, did you see her? She jumped right over her seat. Well, you know what? Just when you thought it couldn't get better on this journey, it does. You see, whoever you're with right now, that's not a person. It's like you're back in your cabin, your stateroom. And that person that you're with is your long-lost teddy bear when you were a little kid. And you love to squeeze that teddy bear now. Really give it up. Enough of that, you two. You panda, you. Dan, what do you think you're doing? Dan, what grade are you in?
Dan, you play sports?
Yeah.
What do you play?
Basketball.
So you're like a well-rounded athlete. When you say play any of those sports, you ever get angry?
Yeah.
Contain the anger, yeah. Huh? Contain it up here, okay? Okay, sleep. Deep in relaxation. We're gonna have some fun with Dan, because I think he's gonna be a fun fellow to have fun with. What do you think, Dan? Dan, on the count of three, if you want to wake Dan, you're having a heck of a time. You're not showing a whole lot of emotion. You're looking pretty cool up here. However, anytime I scratch my nose, you think I pinch your bum. Anytime I scratch my nose, I pinch your bottom so hard you get super upset with me. Super upset. You can see it on your face. Please do not swear, do not say anything foul because we're amongst, people in a school. And whatever you do, do not touch me, whatever you do. That's happened before. Anytime I scratch my nose, you look at me as if I just pinched your bottom and you really know it's me that did it. You get super angry and upset. And whatever you do, do not touch me. 1, 2, 3, eyes open. Okay, we're almost ready to begin. We're going to have some fun. I got to, reiterate that you cannot leave your seats unless I ask you to, okay? Again, the safety thing, I know that it sounds like I'm beating it up here in terms of a dead horse, but you have to stay safe up here and you can't move out of your seat, especially you. Yeah. You understand that, right, Dan? Yeah. So, Dan, you play a lot of sports? I got to ask you, right? And you're in grade 11? So, grade 12. Do you have any ideas what you're going to do in the future, like after school?
No.
Marketing. Marketing? Okay. We'll find out a little bit more about that later. You having fun so far? Yeah? How about now? What's that? Damn. You okay? What just happened?
You touched me.
Damn! I'm not like a magician where my, you know, like my arms are here, Dan. Look at it. My arms are here. I can't touch you unless you see that. Dude, what just happened?
Don't touch me.
Hilarious. Who's your favorite movie star?
Ryan Reynolds.
Really? Sweet. Count to three of you right away. Upon awakening, you feel great. When I say the word movie star, I'll point to one person in this audience here, and you think it's Ryan Reynolds. You'll go over and you'll give the biggest hug in the world. Anytime I say the word movie star, whoever I point to, you'll think it's Ryan Reynolds. You'll jump up, you'll get super excited, and you'll go give this person a big hug. 1, 2, 3, eyes open. Hey! Running the show here. Now, your first name? Sarah, you having fun? You having as much fun as Dan? Do you know that there's a special person here tonight?
No.
Well, there's a special person that's really well known. He's like an A-lister in Hollywood. Mm-hmm. Huh? Can I show you? Really? He is a movie star. That guy right there. Wake up. That's Keith. He's assisting me tonight, so please don't do that to him, okay? He's out of high school, so please. You're not gonna do that again, are you? You're not gonna do that again, right? And your name again is? He's a movie star! Wake up. Don't do that, okay? Hey, Dan, it's funny, huh? Is this funny? Get back up here. Sit back in your seats, all of you. And why, yeah, listen to this piece of music. When you listen to this piece of music, you're all going to fall asleep. In slow motion. I want you to listen to this piece of music. Did you listen to this piece of music? Well, in hypnosis, people can go through a roller coaster ride. have their emotions. Now, on the count of three, you realize one thing. The person next to you is the funniest looking person in the world. So funny, in fact, you think that there's something distorted about their face. It's like they're in hypnosis. On the count of three, the person next to you is the funniest looking person in the world. So funny, you laugh uncontrollably. And the more you look at that person, the more you laugh, you think it's the funniest thing in the world. Stay in your seat no matter what suggestion I give you. One, two, and three, absolutely. Hey, Dan, did you see her? Look at her. Hey, Dan, if you think that's funny, look at this. On the count of three, the person next to you will be the saddest person in the world. You'll want to comfort them and you want to cry. One, two, three. Very sad. It's super sad, super sad. On the count of three, the person next to you looks a little strange. You do not get out of your seat, but you just want to keep your distance. One, two, three. Kind of weird. Sarah, right? Yeah. That person doesn't look like a movie star, do they? Wake up, Sarah. Sarah, don't touch him again. Okay? Please don't do that. Get back in your seat. On the count of three, you fall madly in love with the person next to you and you cuddle. One, two, and three. Nice and easy, nice and easy, nice and easy. Wow, you sandwiched you. On three, let's give it up for them all. One, two, and three. Wakey, wakey. Enough of that, enough. You're here for Steve? Brett? What grade are you in, Brett? Hey, at the end of the show, we do a really cool exercise where you get to feel really good and help you achieve your goal or dream. Do you have some goal that you want in life? Some dream? Play hockey, cool. At a high level? Okay, you can be able to focus on that. You ever wanted to dance? It's Brett? Okay, anybody tell you that you look like Justin Timberlake? Just move on a little bit more, Brett. Sleep. Deep into relaxation. Breath. Deeper, deeper. Count three, you wide awake. Upon awakening, you don't think you're going to dance up here. You don't really like dancing, as you said. However, when you hear the next piece of music, you become Justin Timberlake. And you're here for one reason only. You're here to bring sexy back. So you got to get on this square, the front stage here, and you got to dance your dance as if you're bringing sexy back, and you really get into it, and do not hold back. It's when you hear the next piece of music, you are, like Justin Timberlake, the greatest dancer, you'll be doing the sexy back dance. One, two, three, guys. Brett? Is it Brett? You can bring 10? Wow, it looks like you're grade 12. You just look very mature, very old. You sure you're not going to do any dancing up here? Oh, no, that's a weak word, because you will. Sit down, okay? So, I wanna just ask Dan here, did you think that was, he's pretty good, eh? Yeah. You ever seen Beyonce do her ladies dance? You can can kind of see where this is going, huh? Next time I scratch my nose, Dan gets super mad, pissed at me. He'll stand up, but he does not touch me. Dan, can I make amends and just say, are we friends? How about now? Okay. Whoa, you got pipes on you. You're a doll. Stay there. Don't touch me. I tell you, you probably want to hurt me, is that right?
Yeah.
Anger's coming out.
Yeah.
Hold on. Let's switch gears. Because when you hear the next piece of music, you turn into Beyonce and you do the single ladies dance. So, Panda Man, your name? Chris, you want to see the coolest stuff in the world? This stuff is so cool, it puts people to sleep. Let me show you this. It's sleep dust. Yeah, you want to see how it works? Okay, watch. All right. Stay in your seat. Sit back. Whoever it lands upon falls asleep.
What about him too? Wow. Helps us.
Dan, don't fight it. Okay, you get to take it, and you get to dance around and blow it in people's faces, and they'll go to sleep instantly, and you become the Sandman. Okay?
Pussycat Dolls on our stage.
Yeah, so we'll just get a few of these. That's it. Okay. You're all the Pussycat Dolls, and you have the highest voice of them all. Hair may not look all the best, but let me tell you, your body wiggles like no one else. So you're a Pussycat Doll, you're a Pussycat Doll, you're a Pussycat Doll, you're a Pussycat Doll, and you're a Pussycat Doll. Very high voices, ladies, and you're a Pussycat Doll. And you all come out front and center, and all this noise is for them. On the count of three, let's hear it for the Pussycat Dolls, as well as all of you ladies on stage. You're going to go crazy for them. You're going to make lots of noise because they are definitely not expected to be here, and you all love them. On the count of three, let's hear it for the Pussycat Dolls. One, two, and three! Come on, Pussycat Doll. Come on, Pussycat Doll. Come on, Pussycat Doll. Pussycat Doll. Come on, let's go. Yeah. The Pussycat Dolls are here. Wake up, wake up. Cat Dolls are here. Okay. Contain yourself. Ladies, contain yourself. We have the Pussycat Dolls here. Okay. So, I want to ask you a couple questions. First of all, Bella was asking you to come in for the fundraisers. What do you want to say to your fans? Thanks for coming out. What do you want to say? Love them all?
Yeah.
Yes. And say a few words.
You're welcome.
Yeah. And you've got a really high voice. What do you want to say?
You're sexy.
I hope I'm pretty hot.
Yes, you are. And you're like the leader, so what do you want to say?
Love you all.
Okay, on three. Watch them perform and they really get into it. One, two, three. Guys. Okay, Chris, over here, Chris, I think it's Chris, right, with the blonde hair? Oh, no, who's with the blonde? Oh, it's Brett, right? Okay, get that silly wig on again, and all of you others get back to the stage. Okay, you guys are supposed to be on stage, and this is, yeah. Get back in your seats. Brett, stay right there. Dan, stay right there. Stay right there. You guys come back on stage. Dan, you know what I'm getting you to stay right there? So you can't hurt me. Okay. You can go back on stage, you guys. Okay, except you. Right? What were you doing out there? Huh? Were you looking for somebody? No? I think you were. You had that fellow right there? That fellow is Ken, and when you hear the next piece of music, you become Barbie Girl and you dance with Ken. I thought you didn't like dancing, so just kind of in a wig as well. It's silly. Okay, that's ridiculous. Let's see what else is in store here. Okay, first of all of you sit back. If you're to do any dancing up here, which you probably will, you're going to do it in a very controlled manner. You are going to be in this area, you're going to do it in a very controlled manner, just because I want to make sure, again, you're safe over here. But I got to tell you, when I was in Australia a few years ago, a company gave me a really cool toy. Now, this toy may not look like much, but it is a sleep boomerang. I'm just going to pull it out. Here it is. And I know that you're all pretty wise to it. In fact, when I throw it around, you'll all duck. The next time around, it will get you. In fact, because we've got two rows up here, this is the way it's going to work. It'll hit you guys first, and you'll all fall asleep, but you stay in your seat, especially you. And then as it comes around again, because you all duck, it'll get you the second time around and go all to you. You'll all fall asleep, you all stay in your seat. Watch how this works. The sleep boomerang. I know you're a little scared, aren't you? Especially you, Duncan. Watch. You're now part of the World Wayne Lee Imaginative Dance Group. I want you to think in your head how you're going to do this dance. You're going to start to warm up. In fact, sit up and keep your eyes closed. Start to stretch. And as you start to stretch, in a few moments, you will open your eyes and you'll take this stage as if you are the greatest dancers in the world, starting out very slow. And any time I ask you to freeze like mannequins, you'll stay solid, upright, standing. But right now, you're going to give it your all, and you're going to move the music, and all of you will clap along with them on the count of three. One, you're starting to stretch. Two, you believe you're the world's greatest dancer on this next town. Show us your stuff. And it happens now. Three, open your eyes. Now take the stage. Start to do your dance. Sleep standing now. Let's give them all a big round of applause. Stuck there, stuck there, stuck there, sleep standing. Perfectly still mannequins. You're strong, stay strong. Well, now we're going to kick it up a level, kick it up a notch. You all have this motivation within you, have this spark of creation in terms of your dance. On a count of three, you stay up on stage, but you get to do your dance at a higher level. And you get to make sure you encourage them with your clapping. One, two, and three. As a use the stage. Stay standing. What happened to her? And now close your eyes, Strong Legs Sleep Standing. Let's give all of a round of applause, Stuck There. Well, it's come a point in time where we're going to wrap this up with a very positive suggestion. For all of you on stage, I want you to think of yourselves as somebody that can do anything and that anything is possible. You did an amazing job performing here tonight, and now you're going to transfer that same performance into achieving your goals. So I want you to think of one goal that you really want to achieve. Whatever it is, make it big, bold, blow it up in your mind, and start to think about it now. And as you do that, in a moment, I'm going to get you to take your seats. When you sit in your seats, you're definitely going to be thinking about that goal. I'm going to give you a suggestion that will help you achieve it. On the count of three, take your seats. One, two, and three. Eyes open. There's probably only one thing that will throw this off, and it's probably Dan. Dan's probably going to be throwing this off because when I do this, he gets more mad than ever. Dan, you ready? You thinking about your goal? Okay. Just don't hurt me, okay? Okay. You do want to hurt me, don't you? Right? You do not. Give him a big round of applause. So before we do the last suggestion, you guys were awesome here tonight. And thank you very much for being safe up here. Thank you very much for focusing. What I need you to do right now is join hands with the person next to you on the other side, because you were awesome up here. We're going to do one thing for you. Right now I need you to stand up and reach for the sky. Swing this piece of music that way and that way. Tonight and every night. You're on a count of three, I'm going to say the word energy. When I say that word, I hope you're going to stand still, bow to the music, and just watch yourselves in the back so when you're bowed, you don't hear the chairs. And when they continue to bow, I need you to give them the biggest, loudest round of applause in the world. One, two, and let's hear it. Three. Thank you so very much. It's a little more to go. So all of you can now just take your seats. Make sure that you bring in your seats forward a bit. All of you bring your seats forward a bit. Perfect. And for the last time tonight on the stage, whatever you do, do not go out and hug somebody, even if I say the word movie star. Okay, Katie, wake up. Okay. Please stop that. Okay, get back to you. You're not going to do that again, are you? Sarah, is it? Movie star. Okay. Wake up. Okay. That's not Ryan Reynolds. Now sit back in your seats. When I close my hand or fist, close your eyes, sleep in your seat, stay in your seat. Deep breath in. 3, 2, 1, sleep. Stuck in your seat. Stuck in your seat. Thanks for the catch. Well, all of you did an amazing job. Didn't they do an amazing job here tonight? Stay there. And now we're going to remove any of the suggestions. So all of the suggestions that you follow during the performance, they're all completely removed subconsciously, consciously, and subliminally, so you won't think that I'm pinching your bottom anymore, Dan. And all of the suggestions are completely removed. Upon awakening, it'll feel as though you've had 8 to 10 hours of sleep. You'll feel fully recharged, energized, ready to go, and when you do go to sleep, wherever that's going to be, all you have to do is flip your pillow over, put your head on that pillow, and you'll be out like a light. You wake up 5 to 10 minutes before your alarm clock goes off, you feel great, and then, well, throughout, whenever you get up, feeling happy and successful really depends upon the choices you make in life. I'm going to give you a super duper suggestion to feel good anytime you want so you can achieve more of your goals. So I want all of you right now, in order to receive this suggestion fully, is sit up and keep your eyes closed. As you do this, I want you to pick out one goal that you're really passionate about. It could be a future goal way off in the future, it could be something short term, but something that you're really pumped and charged about.
And in a moment, you're going to start to picture and imagine it. And when you do, there'll be a point where you will feel as though you've achieved it, just like you did up on stage here with all the things you've done. And that point, you'll be able to create an association so you can always trigger yourself to feel good and perform better and get whatever you want in life. So I want you right now just to start to imagine what you want. Smile. Create a very powerful mental expectancy. And as you do this, I want you to really make it clear in your imagination. Make it big. Make it bold and really, really believe as if you're going to achieve it. As you do this, when I count to three, you're going to feel one of the greatest feelings in the world. You're going to feel as though you've already achieved it. You're going to celebrate the yes. And keep your eyes closed so you stay within the feeling and you don't get distracted. On the count of three, feeling the best feeling you've ever felt, complete, 100% success. One, two, happens now. Three. Yes. You did it. You did it. You really did it. And keep your eyes closed and let that feeling flow throughout your body. As it flows throughout your body, it's like a stream of success. And there's a color to that stream. I want you to lock onto that color and think of it now. See it, feel it, taste it, touch it, and notice this. And know this. That from this day forward, anytime you think of that color or see it, you'll feel so good that you'll do one thing every day until you've achieved your dream, your goal. It'll motivate you to such a great degree that you'll move forward to do one thing every day to achieve your dream. You want more of that feeling? Sure you do. It's the air that you breathe. Just reach out, grab some air, and pull it into your heart. When your hand touches your heart, that feeling magnifies 100 times more. So completely, so fully, that you feel so fully charged, that anytime you think of that color, put your hand to your heart, boom, bam, shazam, you're on fire and you go forward in the direction of your goals. Once you've achieved them, you move on to the next. Now that you know that to be so very true, ingrained in your mind, body, heart, and soul, I'm going to descend the numbers from 3, 2, 1. You're going to fall asleep again and let all this sink into your subconscious, always to be recalled by thinking of your color and putting your hand to your heart. When you do go into that deep state of relaxation, stay in your seat. 3 going down deeper, 2 going down deeper, 1, sleep. Nice and easy. And as you go deeper in relaxation, on the count of 3, you'll all be wide awake. Upon awakening, you feel super fantastic. However, you forget everything that you did up on the stage. You don't even believe you're up here for more than 5 or 10 minutes, nor are you even hypnotized. But before you leave the stage, I'll snap my fingers and say the word recall. At that precise moment, you'll remember everything you did. And your facial expression will definitely let them know how great they did. And for the next 10 minutes, and only the next 10 minutes, when you hear this one word, Belrose, you'll have this uncontrollable, urgent desire to stand up, shake your hips, and very loudly say, I feel good. So, for the next 10 minutes, anytime anyone says the word Belrose, you'll stand up, shake your hips, and very loudly say, I feel good. After 10 minutes, it's completely removed. Now, let me just warn you. Do not say Belrose until they're off the stage because it will confuse them. And whatever you do, do not follow these guys into the washer and say Belrose when they're there. On the count of 3, you'll all be wide awake, and all this applause is for them. Oh, and a couple asides. If you want to know where you can collect, just go to my website, WayneLee.com. If you're on Facebook, you can just friend me. I'd love to connect with you because I have all my scheduling on there as well. As well as if you want to receive some free programs, self-hypnosis programs, go to my website. You can just sign up and you get a self-confidence and stress reduction program. And there's many more downloads in regards to signing up. So, and if you have any questions, we'll be here just for about 20 minutes and then we're going to get out. We're going to get out of here. So, best of luck and best of success with staying up all night. On the count of 3, all this applause is for these people. 1, calmly, peacefully, and restfully back to the wonderful waking state. 2, let your whole body's been washed with crystal clear water. On this next count, eyes open, awake, aware. And it happens now. 3! Let me give you a side five, okay? I gotta go from this end here. You guys were awesome. first of all, do you remember what you did up here? Duncan, this is the second time up here, right? Dan, first time? Did you have a good experience? Do you remember? You up here for an hour and 10 minutes, hour and 50. You don't remember what you did? Well, you're about to. And you are very at me. You were awesome up here. What's your name?
Katrina.
Katrina, what's the color that makes you feel good? That feels good?
Yeah.
Put your hand in your heart. That's how that feels. Good? So it's a little tool that you can use anytime you want, when you're feeling down, feeling stressed, or you just want to feel better. Think of your color, put your hand to your heart. So just think of your color now that makes you feel good. Got it? And put your hand to your heart. A lot of people feel bad for no good reason, so you need to feel good for no good reason. Now that you're feeling so good, I need to get you to remember what you did. On count three, I'm going to snap my fingers, I'm going to say one word, and you'll remember everything you did. When you see their facial expressions, let them know how good they were. This is how it works.